again.
Fire up.
Hey, glad you could stay with us on Outdoor Quest TV. I'm TJ Schwanke, and today we're in Australia. And we're with Simon Kyle Little, Australian Big Game Safaris. Tell us a little bit about where we're hunting.
Well, TJ, we're in Arnhem Land,
yep.
Which is a vast Aboriginal territory in northern Australia. It's about 12 million acre reserve, and I'm out here really in probably the remote area of Arnhem Land in the east. It's a big chunk of land, no fences. I've been out here since 1988 when I first came in, and been hunting it ever since. I got excited back then, and I'm still excited now.
Yeah, this is real deal wild hunting out here, isn't it?
It really is, and that's why I'm in it, because I've always sought something real, and I want to have the freedom of hunting properly and hunting dangerous game in their environment, and not just do it so-called just because it's a business to do. I do it because it's exciting and I enjoy every minute of this area.
Well, I mean, your reputation certainly precedes you. I've talked to so many people about you, and even people who've never met you going, "You're hunting with Simon, that is the place to go."
I wouldn't go far as to say that.
I would.
Seriously.
So
no, I don't. Look, this area makes me as well, trust me.
Yeah.
This helps me a lot. It's when people go out of here, they realise they have been somewhere special, and it's the Aboriginal owners that have preserved it that way, and I owe it to them.
Why don't you grab the maps, show us where we're going,
yeah,
and
sure,
we'll get
sure.
out.
At the moment, we're here on the Walker River. Our camp's just north side of the river there. Each one of these is a square kilometre, and there's many maps that make up the concession, but for purposes today, I've just marked in a blue line some of the bush tracks that we have going through this particular map area. These open areas are floodplains, what we call floodplains. This one here is about 20, 30,000 acres of just pure open flats. Lots of buffalo in around where the creeks and waterholes are at the moment in the open. And we have taken some big trophies out there, but generally we find our big buffalo up against the ranges along these feeder creek systems and the multiple waterholes. People often ask me, when's the best time to hunt, what month? We kill big buffalo all through the year, right from the beginning of the season to the end. And I mean, I get asked which month. Well, it's the most common asked question. We just move around and change our hunt plans according to where the animals are. That's
right.
How it works.
Okay.
It's that simple.
Alrighty. Well, first time in Australia, we're hunting buffalo. So Simon's seen he thinks there's a pretty good bull out there, so we'll go get a closer look. He's kind of right on the edge of a big swamp there.
That bull, TJ, is a top-class trophy. He's got a 45-inch spread.
Really?
Yeah, he's a big bull.
He looks huge.
He's bloody, yeah, he is huge.
Yeah.
There's no way we can get to him over that water. That's just it. But
yeah.
I know where he is,
yeah.
And we can get to there. Make a plan for that. But today, at least, if we don't spook him, there may be an opportunity later. We get around there later on today, even possibly to hunt that bull. Yeah.
Outdoor Quest TV is brought to you by Zeiss Sport Optics. We make it visible. Hornady, accurate, deadly, dependable. Coeur d'Alene Sporting Goods, home of the Rocky Mountain Rifle. Outdoor Quest TV is brought to you by Silver Willow Taxidermy, capturing the memories. Loa Boots, handcrafted in Europe. Deluxe Wall Tents, built in Canada for Canadian conditions. Well, finished up lunch and drove a few more miles. We're gonna head into the bush now and see if we can find some bedded up in there somewhere.
Yeah, this is Harris Creek. It's a real secluded kind of place for old buffalo. They hole up in this really dense brush, get away from all the regular herd bulls and cows and stuff. And we do get some cranky buffalo in here too, ones that have been wounded. It is a place we've had a few charges, actually unprovoked ones I'm talking about.
Oh, wow.
You expect one with a bullet in it, but when there's no bullet and they come. So I said to Jim, you know, everyone carries a weapon here.
Okay. Yep. Mm-hmm. Except for the cameraman.
Except for the cameraman.
Yeah.
I can hop my camera.
Yeah. I know I can run faster than her. So.
Yeah, right.
That's good. So we're just going to kind of quietly sneak
through. Yeah, look, we got a bad wind, actually. This is a really difficult creek system to hunt. So I'm gonna cut inland a little bit, and we're going to swing wide. There's a big swamp up here, and we're going to run the edge of that and work our way back into the wind.
Cool.
So that's pretty much the only way to hunt this system. But yep, we never know. Well, I haven't done this for a couple of years. There's not a place I come to regularly.
Yeah.
But on this kind of deal, I like to do it. People that can, you know, a bit more familiarised with hunting, that have got more experience, have been to Africa a few times.
Okay.
Works well.
Up close and personal.
Up close and personal, and it's ideal for the doubles and the big calibers.
Excellent. That was a big bull, Simon, but the challenges of trying to get shooter and camera and everything else on it, he was really like probably one of the thickest spots he could have been in. And there's a couple spots I thought I maybe could have threaded a bullet through, but there was no way to get the camera there, and it wasn't probably a great shot anyways.
The big problem in this long grass is you can't actually see the body. Mm-hmm. And you're shooting into the upper part.
Yeah.
And with that definition of where that leg is to get that angle right, they're a big animal and they can take a lot of lead. So we've got to get our shot right. First up, when we did see him, there was too much of the spear grass in the way.
Yep.
Close up to the actual where you would have fired, so they could have just deflected it slightly.
Yeah.
And on a front, it needed to be dead right. You can't, there's no margin for error.
Right.
So it was pragmatic not to take the frontal shot. We came around and we just got a bit of bad luck there. I thought he might have held. We had him at about 30 yards.
Yeah.
And still couldn't see him properly.
He knew we were there, which made it worse, but he was pretty patient with us, but just, it's fun in here though. This is pretty exciting hunting in here because you're on top of them before you see them.
Yeah.
Is he coming in?
Yeah. So we just finished our hunting day here and we're on our way back to camp, and we just saw this bull on the side of the road, and he is absolutely spectacular. Simon was saying he's over 45 inches and got just incredible weight, so you know, definitely over 100 inches and just a big buffalo. So put a little marker on the side of the road, maybe we can find him tomorrow. Outdoor Quest TV is brought to you by Puma SGB Knives, knife maker to the world since 1769. Defense Aerosols, for when your life depends on it. The Wild Sheep Foundation, putting and keeping sheep on the mountain.
Well, Simon, when we drove up here, I expected that bull to be just standing right there again.
I know you expected that, but it doesn't often work out that way, and we got to go work at it if we're going to look for this buffalo. Yeah. But he was a heck of a brute. Yeah. That was a big bull.
We drove on here just at dark last night, and 24 yards off the road, there was, you said it was probably the best buffalo you've seen this year. That,
we've killed 42 bulls, yeah, which is a big season for us, yeah, but that is the best buffalo I've seen, and without doubt, no question.
Yeah.
Too good to take a chance deal in the low light, mm-hmm, and you know, there is a big heavy trail. He's coming out of that at dark. It must be, I've never actually been in there ever,
yeah,
in the 30 years I've been here, but there would be a little round sinkhole, water,
yeah,
hole.
Yeah.
So we're going there now. We've got a good breeze up.
Well, there just was a bunch of buffalo at that water hole, but we just never could tell if that bull was there or not.
You know, he came out here, and that water hole's 850-odd metres away, and we've assumed that's where he's taking water, but I didn't see his track there.
No.
And, you know, when I found the cows, I thought, well, that was pretty high chance that he may have been with them.
Yep.
And so we went down, went and waited, and they came out, but we could only see really the probably three or four cows plus calves, and they moved off quick, and we followed them, and there was no bull track ahead of them, so.
No, we did the best thing we could, it just didn't
said,
work
wait,
out.
The cows came out to take water, we could have got lucky.
Yeah, exactly.
We could have come out to take water, but it wasn't to be, TJ, yeah, so the hunt goes on.
Yeah, exactly. We're headed to the beach today.
Headed out to the coast, and there are a lot of big buffalo out that way. It's a coastal section of like sand ridges, and behind that's a real heavy jungle, and there are some tremendous bulls out there. Hard to hunt them,
yeah,
but worth a shot. We're targeting where the big buffalo are at, and so far a few have given us a slip. It's not that easy.
No, it's tough
with a television program trying to kill a big buffalo, trust me, but yeah, we've come close. No, it is a great wild preserve. We met some of the Aboriginal owners yesterday. They want this place for hunting and hunting only. It's taken me nearly, well, it's, you know, close on 25 years now to establish that, to get that mindset into the Aboriginal psyche. And, you know, before they hunted for meat, they understand the trophy hunting now and what it brings to them, and they highly value it. So it's great. It's a win-win for both myself and the Aborigines, and they beyond a business, they just actually seem to like it.
Well, stick with us. Some heavy cover, big buffaloes. Never know what's going to happen. Simon, you were saying there's kind of a creek system right along the edge of the ocean there?
Yeah, just over that ridge there, there's this saltwater intrusion, and they've got freshwater behind here, but they're getting out to wallow in those muddy little holes that they like,
yeah,
and that's what they're doing, cooling off these hot days, particularly in the morning. So that's a good system to go look for buffalo this time of day. The rest of it in there, once they get into that jungle, it's over.
It's over.
There's no hunt, yeah.
Yeah. Outdoor Quest TV is brought to you by Safari Club International Canada, first for hunters. Alberta Outdoorsman Magazine, Alberta's only hunting, fishing, and trapping magazine.
Stay in close, the creek is just down here. So, no talking, sip, and we're going to make our way along that. There's going to be buffalo anywhere along those waterholes.
Okay.
The sands, it's good for walking, it's quiet. Yeah. Keep in the sand, keep out of the leaves.
Yeah.
Okay.
There's a buffalo laying in the water there.
Okay.
Straight over that green.
Yeah.
There's a buffalo laying in the water there. Okay, there's a bit muddy water. There's a cow there. It looks like a bull up close, but he's down below, underwater. It looks like a big buffalo.
Yeah.
We can't get that side because of the wind, but I want to be able to get a look at him through here, but we're very open here. So we'll hug this tree line a little bit, but don't want to get too close.
Okay.
I'd rather he move out to see what we've got.
Absolutely.
That cow's looking back this way. I think we'll just wait until either he makes a move and we get to look at him. That cow's facing us. There it is coming up, look. We don't want her to spot us. It's a cow. Okay, they're onto us. I'm not gonna move, just stay there. I'll tell you what to do. Yeah, on the right. The very right. That's him there now. Steps out through those trees. Just watch that cow doesn't spook. He's going to take off. Okay. Take him in the shoulder.
Hit him again. Hit him again. Fire up. That's it. He's down.
Great stuff. You did it. It's a mortal shot. Well done.
Sit here bored for 10 minutes waiting for him to walk out, and then all of a sudden it just gets hairy. They spotted us and he was starting to go,
and I was on the cow and not the bull.
Yeah, you got on him though.
I did get on him.
It's pumping out the shoulder. It's a good clean shot. Two shots. Well done, TJ. Did well, mate. Good on you, bud. No mess up. I like it.
I gotta tell you what, I've hunted a lot all over the world. My heart was going about 150 beats a minute when he was starting to walk out there. That's about as close to buck fever as I've ever had. I really had to just calm, because...
I'm glad you did, because your second shot was fantastic.
Oh.
He actually dropped in his tracks, and well done.
I never do that.
Your cameraman's doing about the same.
That was...
When it happens, it happens. And, you know, it's called a hunt for that reason. It's called a hunt. And that's why you did it perfect. We just had to wait and be calm. Here's another young bull coming out. But the cow he was with, he was on, and that was our opportunity. He was zoned on her. She was the one switched on to us, not him.
She knew the gig.
Absolutely. Totally. Look at that shots, mate. Put it here, buddy. No mucking around. I love it. That is a great trophy buffalo. His, not just his spread, but let me put his gun sight. The length in those horns, he's got probably close on 34.5 in the horn. It's a great bull.
Wow.
Great bull. That's as good a trophy that, you know, of course we've got bigger, but if you're a trophy hunter, you come and get a buffalo like this.
I know, I'm thrilled.
Well, I'm glad you are, because any hunter should be thrilled. It's a great trophy.
Yeah. Well, Simon, we did a lot of stalks on a lot of buffalo, and this one almost didn't work out either. You know, they were lounging away lazily in here when we first spotted them, and all of a sudden they decided it was time to move. They didn't have a clue we were there, but just buffalo being buffalo, isn't it?
You're dead right. They were out of there, and... But no, we'll take a combination of a little luck and good hunting any day of the week.
Yeah.
But, you know, it was our advantage now. We had them in a good position and things came together. And with your good shooting and that, I will say that, we anchored this bull pretty quickly.
I want to thank you so much, Simon.
You're welcome.
You know, you're just a pleasure to hunt with. And I think we're going to go do a little bit of fishing yet and some stuff like that.
We're going to do some other stuff, and you're a pleasure to be with. I must say that I've had the odd TV show here and there, and this has been by far the best show, the best people, and it's real.
Well, you're too kind, and I appreciate that. And yeah.
Make so now check. That we've patted each other on the back, let's go and skin him out.
For more information on hunting with Australian Big Game Safaris, check them out online at australianbiggamesafaris.com.au. Check us out online at outdoorquesttv.com. And don't forget to follow us on Facebook and Twitter.